Didn't you wagwan, one and all. I'm going to use sine squared plus cosine squared theta equals 1 to solve some trigonometric equations. So if you've watched my tutorial proving this identity, this will teach you how to use it. So here's an equation. An equation that features both cosine and sine. And I can't solve an equation which has two different trigonometric ratios without using an identity. And it's the fact that it's got a sine squared that tells me the identity I'm going to be using has squareds in. And I know that the sine squared of theta plus the cosine squared of theta equals 1. Now, this equation doesn't feature a cosine squared anywhere. It only features a sine squared. So I need to know what that is equal to. Rearranging this identity tells me that the sine squared of an angle is equal to 1 minus the cosine of that angle squared. So what I'm going to do is substitute that in where I see sine squared theta. Make sure you don't just write minus 1 minus cosine squared theta. Just think for a moment why that would be wrong. Pause it if you don't spot it instantly. Hopefully you've said, well, because I need to substitute that in for the whole of sine squared theta, and brackets are necessary. It changes what the equation is when I multiply it out. You see I get 5 times the cosine of theta minus 1 minus minus is plus cosine squared theta equals 1. I now have a quadratic equation, and it only features the ratio cosine. So I'm going to tidy this up into a form I've gotten wrong. So here I have an equation that features both cosine and sine. I can't solve equations featuring two different ratios without using an identity. And it's the fact that we've got a ratio squared that tells me I'm going to need to use the identity I just mentioned. The sine of an angle squared plus the cosine of an angle squared is equal to 1. Now, looking at my equation, there's no cosine squareds. There is only a sine squared. So from this identity, I need to know what sine squared is equal to. Quickly rearranging, I can see that sine squared of theta is 1 minus the cosine of theta squared. So where I see sine squared theta, I'm going to substitute in 1 minus the cosine squared of theta. And doing so, the equation becomes 5 cosine theta minus 2 times. Now obviously, I'm going to need to write this in brackets. 1 minus the sine squared of theta is equal to 1. Cosine squared of theta, even. And I'm not going to re-record this because I'm going to show you the mistakes do happen. And that wasn't deliberate. I'm tempted to say that. So there we go. I've substituted in 1 minus cosine squared for sine squared. I've got myself an equation that only features cosine, so I am going to be able to solve this. It's going to take a bit of tidying up, so you may want to race ahead, or maybe you want to keep up with me. Be careful when you multiply out. Minus and a minus makes plus 2 times the cosine squared of theta. Hopefully by now you've spotted that's just a quadratic. So let's write it as we would expect. 2 times the cosine squared of theta plus 5 cosine theta minus 3 equals 0. A quadratic equation in terms of theta and cosine theta only, really. Now, what I'm going to do, and what many of you will be encouraged to do, is what's called a change of variables. It is a quadratic. I am going to be able to solve it, but it's quite difficult to spot. So instead of writing cosine theta every time, I'm going to substitute y in to make it more obvious to me. So this would be 2, instead of cosine squared theta, 2y squared plus 5y minus 3 equals 0. Bog standard quadratic. You can either factorise, complete the square, or use the formula. This does factorise. I'm going to embarrass myself trying to do it so quickly. Don't do it quickly. Use a method. Use one of my tutorials to learn a good method. But we can see here this is going to be 2y minus 1 and y plus 3. A quick check. 2y squared plus 6y minus y minus 3. So it does work, and that's still equal to 0. And then equate each bracket to 0. That would be rearranged to give y is equal to 1/2. And over here, if y plus 3 is 0, y is equal to minus 3. Now, when I get two answers, what I like to do is split the page in half and solve each one completely separately. So remember that y was actually what I was using to say cosine theta. So I can now say that cosine theta equals 1/2. So theta would be the arc cosine of 1/2. Sticking that into my calculator gives me one of the solutions, 60 degrees. It did say theta had to be between 0 and 360, so I'm going to have to find any other solutions that exist. So this is 90, 180, 270, and 360. My calculator's very kindly given me the answer, 60 degrees. And using the symmetry of the cosine graph, I can come back 60 degrees from 360. So theta equals 60 and 300. I've gone over that very quickly. But if you're learning this identity, you should know how to solve trigonometric equations. And if you don't, do watch my tutorial on those as well. Coming over to this side, cosine theta should equal minus 3. Theta equals the arc cosine of minus 3. And sticking it into my calculator, the damn thing says maths error. Now, in the early stages of mathematics, that was a sign that you needed to put your hand up and complain to the teacher. But now, at your level of study, you should know that that means that either you have done something wrong, which is a possibility, or if you've done everything right, simply this gives no valid solutions. There's nothing wrong with that. So in other words, cosine theta can never equal minus 3. That isn't one of the solutions. The only solutions came when theta equals 60 or 300 degrees. If I just zoom out and look at that problem we've done there, you can see there's a lot of working. But what we've done, we've taken an equation, used an identity that we've memorised, and then it's become a lovely equation that we know how to solve. We still had to know quadratics, so that's something you may need to practice, and we've still had to know the graphs, so that maybe have to be something you practice, but you, with enough practice, are going to be able to use identities to solve equations, and that is brilliant. So hopefully, you found that useful. If you did, share it using social media, because you never know who else might need it. And if you need any other help, go to my website, mathormaths.com, or get in touch via Twitter or Facebook. Good luck with any exams, and seriously, well done for revising and working hard. I'm proud of you. So's the puppy.